everything you asked.
Oh, you went to the shop.
Yes, here's the key.
Thank you. Oh, what did you tell him about last night?
I thought you shot yourself. Well, accidentally. I delivered your message to Mr. Novak. Well, his landlady, that is. He wasn't in today.
Very good.
Oh, one more thing. Miss Wallace is sick. Her mother called. She's not going to be in the shop today. That's everything.
Okay, far back. Good.
You are a credit to your profession.
Thank you, Mr. Merchant. Good night. You know, I'm not afraid of responsibility. I welcome it, in fact.
Well, keep that in mind. Good.
And, you know, Christmas is around the corner. All that Christmas shopping. We're going to be very short-handed in the shop.
We'll just have to manage.
But certainly one more clerk would come in handy.
Okay. What is it? Do you know someone who wants a job?
Mr. Barachek, you've got to stop thinking of me as just a delivery boy. In a suit with a tie, I'd look old.
Old?
And I've been training myself to be a sales clerk. Training hard for 2 years.
So you've been trained.
I have trained myself, going shelf by shelf. And I know every item in the store. Every tube, jar, box, bottle, carton, and container. Where they are, what they cost, what they're for. Although it's something I've never thought about, Mr. Merrick, try me. You need a man who knows the business inside out, Mr. Merrick, try me. You need help, or I have never spoken. And why break someone in when I'm already broken? In this emergency, I wouldn't let you down, Mr. Merrick. Try me. Oh, I can see by the uncertain way you frown that you ask yourself, why me? For first class clerking and conscientious working, Mr. Merrick, why not try me?
Okay, fine. This cream is sour.
Very sour. Take it back. What are you?
You wish to return this jar? Not uncertainly right you are. Not if you say it smells like a crowded cat.
It smells.
No.
It does that. And then checks out of the claim with pride. The customer must be satisfied. The customer must be satisfied.
Wait.
By the way, we have a special sale on autumn heather. Let me spray some on your hand. Here, we'll smell it together. It has the three elements of good perfume, attractive to the nose, invisible to the eye, and functional. My wife has used it time and again, it's very appealing to us men. I use it myself every now and then.
Right, fine, I'll take it.
Oh, sir, madam. Oh, Miss Ritter!
Miss Ritter?
And 26 for the autumn heather, 8 and 3 for the cream, 32 even for the love mermaid shoe, 1 and 3 for the eyebrow pencil, 9 for the large shampoo, and then for the jar you're bringing back, that's 4 and 2 for you. That's a total of 98 plus 4 and 2 for the jar, out of 100. Cha-ching! Here's your change, 5 and 2. There you are. I believe. Thank you, madam. Please call again. Glad I could help. Here is my card. Thank you, madam. Please call again. Do call again. Madam. I would gladly grow a mustache if you'd like, Mr. Merrick. Try me. Oh, I would even think of giving up my bike, Mr. Merrick. Try me. For first class parking and conscientious working. Mr. Merchant, why not try me?
Very impressive, Arpad. I think you even managed to shortchange me a bit.
Mr. Merchant.
Oh. George.
What happened?
happened? He shot himself. Accidentally. He's cleaning his gun.
Arpan, would you leave this alone, please?
Yes, sir. Are you in very much pain, Mr. Manager?
Oh, George. The only place it doesn't hurt me is in my left shoulder where it shot myself.
Is there anything that I can do?
George, first I need to do something. Very important. If I could get up, I'd walk up to you and I'd take your hand. And I would beg you to forgive me.
Oh, I forgive you, Mr. Merchant. Whatever happened, whatever it happened, it doesn't matter.
You can't let me off that easily. I did terrible things to you. Terrible! And there's no excuse. Well, except perhaps one excuse. The jealousy of an old man.
Jealousy?
George, still in the dark. You know, I think you're the only person in the world who's ever had an affair and wasn't aware of it.
An affair?
Yes, you're having an affair with my wife.
With your wife? Oh, Mr. Merchant?
I have all the facts.
Oh, but it's not true!
I know it's not true, George, I know. But a week ago, 2 weeks ago, I didn't know.
I can't believe it, I mean, me and him. Hey, did you really think that
I said the point, George? I didn't mean it. I can't get over it. Well, George, if you're willing, I'd like you to take over the shop.
Of course I will. At least keep the doors open until you're well enough to come back.
George, now that you're the boss, maybe you want to give yourself a raise.
Well, I'll have a little talk with myself. And if I don't ask for too much, I'm angry.
The perfect executive. Here's the key. Now you better get going. You're going to be short-handed today. Very short-handed. Arpad tells me Miss Bolish isn't coming in today.
Miss Bolish? Why not?
He says she's sick.
What's wrong with her?
I don't know. He didn't say. But you're going to have to manage without her today. And without another clerk. Mr. Kodai. I want you to fire him!
Fire him?
Just give him 2 weeks, pay.
Well, I didn't realize that Mr. Kodai was so unsatisfactory. He works hard and...
Yes, at the wrong things.
I'm not sure I understand.
Well, if you run into Mrs. Marajack, perhaps she can explain it to you. Well, George, it looks like I'm a bachelor now, just like you. Perhaps you could take me to one of those cabarets you're always going to.
Mr. Marsh,
oh, George, I know you don't go to cabarets. Well, my boy, you better get going.
I'll stop by later with a full report.
I'll be here.
Who is it? Just a
I know you're not. That's why I'm here.
You're sick?
Ow. Well, this may come as quite a shock to you, Ms. Balish, but the fact is, I'm back at Maricek's.
Back at Maricek's?
As of this morning.
And I suppose you've come here to see if I'm really sick. Is that it?
No.
So that you can tell everyone there's not a thing wrong with me.
No.
That I just don't care about my job.
No.
Well, you won't get that chance. What time is it? I won't be very late.
But he told me himself.
He? Himself? yourself?
Dear friend, no one else.
Tell me everything, Mr. Nohan, tell me!
Okay, well, let's see. Well, last night, when I left the cafe, I had the strangest feeling that someone was following me. And I kept looking back, and, well, there was.
A man?
Yes. And when I got closer to home, he came up to me and started asking questions about you and me.
What sort of questions?
Oh, well, just what you'd expect.
I want to know the words, he said.
I'm not very good at remembering.
Try! Please.
Well, I believe the first thing he said to me was, excuse me, can I ask you a question? Or something like that. And then he asked me, did you just leave the Cafe Imperial? You want to know what I said?
Yes.
All right, well, I said, yes.
And then
he said, tell me, that girl you were with, is she a special friend? Those were his words, exactly, special friend. And, well, I said, no, we just work at the same shop. As a matter of fact, she has an appointment with someone else tonight. I'm remembering very clearly now. I remember he suddenly looked quite sad.
He looked sad?
Oh, quite sad. He said, I know she has an appointment. It's with me. But I have to leave town on urgent business.
Urgent business? Is he a manufacturer, do you think? Or a shop owner, maybe?
Oh, well, it's very hard to say. You know, he certainly looked well fed.
Well fed.
To judge by appearances. That's not so uncommon, though, in a man his age. You have some magnificent books here, Miss Polish. Oh, The Red and Black. You know, I've been so anxious to read this. I wonder if I could borrow it sometime.
What did you mean by a man his age?
I beg your pardon.
You said it's not so unusual a man his age. How old is he?
Well, you realize it was a very dark night. And he had had an exhausting day, emotionally at any rate. But I put his age at 50, 60, 70. It's hard to say, really, very at all. You know, perhaps if he had some hair. Have you read The Magic Mountain?
What?
Oh, The Magic Mountain. I bought it for myself for my birthday. If you'd like, I can lend it to you.
Is he completely bald?
Does that matter? I thought you were in love with him.
I am in love with him, Mr. Novak. Really, I am. It's just, I thought, I had hoped. Oh, I'm so ashamed of myself. As if appearances really matter. The important thing is the letters. Just look. At all of the amazing works of art written by elderly men. Bald men. Fat heads. Terrible tempers and indigestion. But somewhere inside, deep inside, they had the magic, and well, that's a glory beyond estimation.
You put it very well, Polish.
I feel very well. I feel marvelous. Thank you, Mr. Novak. Thank you for coming today. Thank you for all of this, and thank you for my life. I'm going to write him. Right this minute. So he has a letter waiting when he returns. But I won't mention you. That might be embarrassing.
Yes, I appreciate that. Well, I should get back to the shop.
And I'll follow, just as soon as I've written the letter.
Oh, no, that won't be necessary. Take the day off, relax, read a book. Have you finished Anna Karenina yet?
Oh, yes, a long time
ago. Well, so did I, but you know it's remarkable how it stays with me. Every platform, every station platform, the train coming in, Anna's platform, wherever it may be. Well, I can see her, actually see her come through the crowd and walk slowly toward her death. I've even tried to stop her a few times, but she always disappears into the smoke and steam.
How odd, Mr. Miller. How very odd. You know, in one of his letters, I wish I could share with you.
You mean to tell me that dear friends have the same experience?
More than once.
Well, goodbye, Miss Balish.
Mr. Novak, can I tell you something quite sincere? I like you. Really, I like you.
Thank you, Miss Balish. I'll see you in the morning.
In the morning. Dear friend, I am so sorry about last night. It was a nightmare in every way. But together, you and I will laugh at last night someday.
Likes me, and tomorrow, tomorrow,
or I mustn't tell her. It's wrong now, but it won't be long now. Before my love discovers that she and I are lovers, imagine how surprised she's bound to be.
Automatically came to a stop. I don't know how long I've been. could solve this problem of mine. I said, huh? He said, if I liked, he'd willingly read to me some of his favorite things. I said, when? He said, now. His novel approach seemed highly suspicious and possibly dangerous.
But you won't be happy for very long. For any day now, those doors will close for the last time. Then, just take a walk on over to Hammerschmidt's.
Why? It's closed.
For now. For 3 nations. You see, they're going to have a new owner. Stephen Koda.
Some owner.
Elona believes me. Don't you, darling?
Of course I do. Here's your down payment.
Sherry.
These are the people who shop the time.
I don't think I can take it. I haven't stopped for a second.
I waited on 53 customers personally.
If only Mr. Maritek were here.
Oh, I'll stop by the hospital tonight and I will take this with me. Well, it's coming. She's going to invite me home for Christmas Eve.
Well, split it!
Why split it? I can't go. Tonight's the night she finally meets dear friend.
But your dear friend.
That's just the point.
That's it. I give up. Too confusing. You want to untangle this? Shoot yourself.
Oh, my. Amalia, my friend is coming to pick me up. Will you let me know when he gets here? Mr. Novak, my mother and I would be so happy if you'd join us for Christmas Eve.
Ms. Balish.
It's going to be a very special Christmas Eve. Do you know who's going to be there? Dear friend.
Who?
Dear friend, the man I've been corresponding with, remember?
Oh, yes. I certainly don't want to intrude.
Oh, intrude? You'd be helping. After all, you know him. You've met him, and the two of you are so alike. You can help me when the conversation gets too deep for me. Please?
I just certainly hope this isn't a mistake.
I know it isn't.
Mr. Maritek! Look who's here! It's Mr. Maritek!
Well, happy Christmas Eve!
Merry Christmas, sir!
You did all that in a day?
Merry Christmas, sir. I thought I heard your voice. Uh-huh. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Miss Ritter. You have time for a drink?
Ooh, champagne. I'll make time.
Mr. Maritek! Such a surprise!
Oh, Merry Christmas, Mr. Seabos. Would you round us up 6 cups?
Of course, sir.
Shall we open it? I love opening champagne.
Didn't bring it closed.
Yeah, how are you feeling, Mr. Maritek?
Excellent.
The goblet, sir? Ah.
The champagne. Shall I pour?
Of course.
Ooh, it's red. My wife's sister. and her children. And God knows who else! Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Arpad.
Yes, sir.
Do you have plans tonight?
No, sir.
You do now. You're going to Faber's.
Oh, Faber's!
What is it?
George, Arpad and I are going out for a night in town.
Oh.
Merry Christmas, Mr. America.
Merry Christmas, Miss Bosch. Merry Christmas, sir.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Novak.
Merry Christmas.
I'm off the vapors.
Mr. Laszlo, is there anything special you would want for Christmas?
It doesn't matter.
Well, what is it?
I shouldn't say.
Oh, come on. At least tell me.
You wouldn't get it for me anyway. But, you know, what I'd want more than anything is a motorcycle.
You're right, my boy. You won't get it.
Dear friend, I had to tell